Brian and John are testing the well-worn movie myth that after a generic bad guy is decapitated, there's a dramatic pause.
The problem we're having right now is speed. We need much more of it. That cut has to happen so fast that we're building a rocket sword.
It's going to be exactly as ridiculous and dangerous as it sounds. A medieval rocket-powered sword.
Oh, yeah. Ta-da.
Designed to decapitate.
The key to getting maximum speed out of our rocket sled is reducing the weight so the rockets don't have to push a heavy load across the 50 feet of our track. So that's why I'm making the rig as minimal as possible, making it out of aluminum, which is really light and strong. Yeah, that'll work.
In addition to setting up the track along which the rocket blade will run.
All right, rocket force test in 3,
Brian's
two,
doing some rocket science.
That was a great test of our rockets. We got about 23.8 newtons of force.
Which means with the sled weighing...
about 4.5 kilograms.
And adjusting for friction, 20 rockets will send their sword flying...
Fire!
At more than 150 miles an hour.
Fire!
Twice the speed of a human swing.
Go, 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 go! Fire! One more! That's not bad.
I think that's ready for rockets.
Our rig is set up to test whether or not a blade moving with enough speed can cut clean through our target while leaving it completely intact. But first, we're gonna do a dry run without a target just to make sure everything works smoothly.
Perfect.
For this dry run test, we're looking for 3 things. Are our tracks aligned? Are we getting the forces we need from the rockets? And what is the optimum position for our target?
Eyes and ears and hats on. So cool. Ooh, I'm nervous. Here we go. Rocket sled dry test in 3, 2, 1.
I think that's successful.
It's like Christmas.
It's beautiful.
We're good.
Well.
Like you hit the end of the track and it went, just. The rocket sled performed exactly how we wanted to. Everything worked fantastically. In terms of power and speed, I think we got it. I think I'm gonna just wipe it down, get some of the schmutz off, and tighten a few things, and we'll set up for the next test.
It's a magnificent and terrifying sight to behold. A razor-sharp blade powered by rockets launched at 165 miles an hour.
Our dry run went great. We got the results we were looking for. But before we graduate to the final event, we're gonna have a soft target test.
Okay, just stay here and I will be right back. Ignition, engage. Oh, there it is. Okay. I will count you down, bro.
Oh, I can't wait to fire the chicken.
Okay. Rocket blade sled at target. Just stay there, chicken, it'll be okay. In 3, 2, 1. Food.
Well, actually,
bring it on over.
It's a pretty good half chicken.
Whoa, that's not bad. Look at this. It cut through the bone the long way.
That is a perfect cut through there. That's impressive.
Whoa. Okay, that blade traveled straight through the chicken. Super clean cut. Look at that juice flying everywhere.
He's barely meatball.
And then it gets railroaded.
So there's a slight problem with the rig. The back end of the sled crashes into the target. If there was a dramatic pause, it was run over. For the final test, the guys add a backstop. Oh, and a zombie.
To test this, we need a target to fit the myth. That's why we have a zombie.
This is Larry. He used to be one of our Mythbusters production assistants, that is, until the outbreak. But now he's volunteered to be our target. Thanks, Larry.
You're welcome, John.
I'll turn the key, you flick the switch.
Sure.
Bad boys for life. Here we go. Okay. Rocket blade test with very nervous zombie in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, what the hell is going on?
Fire extinguisher, please. That was spectacular. Oh!
You ready for this?
Yeah. Oh, it chopped through skin, tissue, bone. Wait, where's the head?
Where is the head, man?
Oh! Woo, scared me a bit. Oh, let's look at the, look how clean this cut is.
That's incredible, like the bone and the flesh, man.
Clean cut. However, I did see the head roll off. But I can't tell if because everything was shaking or if it stayed and then lopped off. We'll have to check the high speed. Here we go.
Oh, there
here it comes.
Slicing it. That could not have more precision or power.
But you can see as the blade is drawing across our target that it like starts to push into it. And it causes the head to roll off.
Yeah, like no delay, even on high speed.
Nope.
The myth, much like the burning remains of the rocket sled,
flames everywhere,
is toast.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Delayed causality, what do you think?
I mean, even with a rocket sled and a super sharp blade, couldn't get the head to stay on.
Yeah, it works great in the movies, but in real life, busted.
Busted.
Busted!
Just glad the world's safer with one less zombie.